Dear student, very good morning to all of you. Welcome to the online lecture series of environmental science. In the previous lecture, we were discussing about the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974, and we were discussing about the functions of CPCB or Central Pollution Control Board. Some of the functions already discussed. We proceed further. Next function is to organize a comprehensive program for spreading information through mass media. Mass media may be in two different forms. It may be print media and it may be electronic media. Print media may be in the form of newspapers, newsletters, magazines, prospectus, etc. And electronic media may be dissemination of information through or awareness through radio, transistor, television, etc. Next function of the CPCB is to provide trainings related to the control and abatement of water pollution. Similarly, next function of the CPCB is to collect, compile, publish technical and statistical related to water pollution. Means CPCB has got the power to collect the data, information, and compile the same information that must have been collected from different states or different areas, and technically compile such collected data into a very compiled form which are all related to the water pollution. The next function, collection of data and compilation. Next function of CPCB is to prepare manuals, guides and codes for the treatment and disposal of sewage and trade effluents. Prepare manuals means the function of the CPCB is to prepare, collect and compile data related to the water pollution. In CPCB is supposed to collect information and data and compile the same collected data related to the water pollution collected from the different areas or from the different states. It has also got the powers to lay down standards. Lay down standard means before establishment of any particular industry or any particular unit, every industry or the every unit is supposed to submit that how much amount of pollution in the form of water pollution is going to produce or going to discharge from the said industry, and the industry is supposed to remain within the permissible limit already given by the CPCB, or the unit itself is submitted and consented not to discharge above that permissible limit. So a lay down standard means already a fixed limit has been given to the particular industries or units, and the same standard or the limits is also fixed by Central Pollution Control Board. CPCB has one more function of planning nationwide programs for control and abatement of water pollution. Means throughout the India, CPCB is supposed to program nationwide programs, in fact, for control and abatement of water pollution. One more function of the CPCB is to establish an environmental laboratory. Establish an environmental laboratories means if we are collecting a data from somewhere, then we are supposed to analyze the data, how much of the pollutant load is containing by the particular discharge it releasing from a particular industry, then there must be a laboratory, which we say environmental laboratories, to analyze the collected sample so that the data or the statistics may be provided, may be disseminated, may be published. So they also establish a laboratory for analyzing those collected samples. This was all about the functions of the CPCB. Now we discuss the function of SPCB. Functions of SPCB. SPCB means State Pollution Control Board. In the very function of the CPCB, you learn that CPCB was supposed to advise the central government about the matters related to the water pollution. Same is the case with here. First ever function of the State Pollution Control Board to advise the state government. Advise state government about the issues, about the technicalities, about the advancements related to the water prevention and control of pollution. Similarly, it has also got the powers to lay down standards in the vicinity of the particular area of any sewage or effluent releasing from any particular industry or any particular unit. The board has also got the powers, its SPCB has got the powers to take samples from any particular industry. Got the powers to take samples. Sample means the discharge. As I already told you, every industry has given a fixed amount of pollutant load. The industry is supposed to discharge, and industry is not supposed to discharge above the permissible limit already given. So such samples may be collected for the analysis, for determination of the pollutant load in that very particular discharge. It may be a sewage or it may be an effluent releasing or discharging from a particular industry. So board has got the power to take samples from that particular industry or that particular unit. But while taking samples, legal formalities are supposed to be met. Means while taking samples, both the parties should be present there. Means both the parties, in the sense, one, the owner of the industry or who runs the industry or the person who is taking the sample, and person taking the sample may be a member of State Pollution Control Board. Means there must be two members. One member belong to State Pollution Control Board and another member must be present there while taking the samples, be the occupier or who runs the unit or the industry. And completion of the legal formalities means after the sample is taken, the sample must be sealed and signed by both the parties. After the completion of the sample has been taken, member of the SPCB and the occupier or the runner or the owner of the industry is supposed to sign and seal, and such sample is sent to the laboratory, is already established for analyze of pollution load. Means after supposed to send, the environmental laboratory is already established for further analysis and for further sampling to determine whether the industry is releasing the pollutant load within the permissible limits or above the permissible limits. And if we find that the industry is releasing the pollutant load above the permissible limit given, then the industry becomes defaulter. If the industry releases or discharges above permissible limit, then industry becomes defaulter. As I already told you, if any industry or occupier is not releasing the pollutant load in agreement with the CPCB or SPCB, as the case may be, the industry or the occupier becomes defaulter, and the defaulter may be prosecuted, made imprisonment, or the occupier or the fine may be imposed. Means if any occupier or the industrialist become defaulter, the defaulter may be prosecuted, made imprisonment, or fine may be imposed depending upon the amount of discharge they have released in excess to the permissible limit already given to that particular industry. This was an overview about the water pollution control, water prevention and control of pollution Act 1974, and this was only about an overview as per the demand of the syllabus for the UG courses for first and second semester. Despite certain weaknesses in the Act, Water Act has gotten ample provisions and controlling the water pollution in a large amount, but the need is not to only keep the eyes on the government or the acts, but at individual level we are supposed to act ourselves for control about the water pollution is water is an indispensable source of the nature, and in no way we are not supposed to lose the quality of the water. So becomes the duty of every citizen to control water pollution. In the next very lecture, we will discuss another important law. So attend the next classes. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Best of luck.